So this is a bit odd. What do you think is going on? Well, there is one way to find out. It's to join me after this. Thanks for sticking around. This trick can be done by boiling water in the bottom of a flask, a little bit like the old sort of getting a hard-boiled egg into a bottle trick. But George Gross, link below, was asking himself if it would be possible while he was doing an ammonia fountain demonstration to achieve the same kind of an effect by just dissolving some ammonia gas into the flask. And the result is pretty neat. Because of the rapid pressure changes that we're going to be achieving here, we will need to be using some borosilicate flasks, and of course we'll be loading them with ammonia. Now, the last time we spoke about fountain effects was just over 10 years ago, and this chap with the slightly stronger London accent and significantly more hair than this guided us through the process of collecting ammonia gas in a dried flask. But Kleeps have updated a couple of details since then, so let's revisit. Before you do anything, you don't want to go to the trouble of filling a flask only to find that you can't get the balloon over the end. So the first thing that I would recommend that you do is try that out. Trust me, I learn these lessons so that you don't have to. It's handy as well to pre-stretch the balloon, and it ensures that you aren't using some old ones that may have perished a little bit. I've left some borosilicate flasks up to about 500 centimeter cubed in size in the oven overnight to thoroughly dry. You could also rinse with propanone and leave that to evaporate. About 10 centimeter cubed of ammonia in a boiling tube will be more than enough for a flask, and I was able to fill a few for this video just from one boiling tube. Although if you are filling larger items like gas jars, then Kleeps definitely recommends using a fresh boiling tube of concentrated ammonia each time you do this. And because we're using concentrated ammonia, that's why I'll be working in a fume cupboard and wearing splash-proof goggles and, of course, gloves. So, as I say, wear gloves when you're transferring concentrated ammonia solutions. Transfer that liquid carefully, avoiding skin contact, and then add a few anti-bumping granules. Ammonia is less dense than air, so set up your flask inverted overhead with a long delivery tube nearly to the top. Then raise and lower a beaker of freshly boiled water around the concentrated ammonia to control the gas evolution. The ammonia will boil off at around 55 degrees Celsius. In the past, you may have tested for the flask being totally full by holding some dampened indicator paper at the opening of the flask. Apparently this isn't such a reliable technique, and so Kleeps have updated their guidance and say just leave the flask for about 5 minutes to ensure that it is completely filled. Now that's for a gas jar, so clearly if you're working with smaller vessels you won't need quite so long. Stop at the flask and leave it inverted. Now, if you're feeling brave, or if you have some really nice, big, flexible balloons to hand, you could do the whole balloon filling thing right in front of your audience. But again, I've learned the hard way that having someone nearby to help you get the end of the balloon on can be useful. So just before the lesson, I do the following. Inject a few centimeter cubed of water into the balloon. Ammonia is so soluble, it doesn't really matter how much. I've popped a bit of tubing on the end of the syringe so that I don't get the neck of the balloon wet. Of course, that would defeat the purpose. Place a Hoffman clip or similar fastening on the neck to make sure that you don't accidentally squeeze the liquid when getting the balloon over the neck. And then, working with the flask inverted in a fume cupboard, stretch the balloon neck over the flask. This can be fiddly, so having a person on hand to help is wise. This can now be left until you're ready to do the demo. To show the experiment, make sure you're wearing eye protection, and if not currently working in a fume cupboard, then protect the audience and yourself with safety screens. Remove any clips and right the flask. Textbook diagrams of particle arrangements often give a misleading scale when it comes to gases. you could get the impression that gases are just a little bit more spread out than liquids, but the ammonia gas takes up vastly more volume than it does in the solution. So when you lift the end of the balloon, the ammonia dissolves phenomenally well in the water, the pressure drops in the flask, and the surrounding air pushes the balloon inside with a satisfying pop. The nice thing when you're done is that you're left with a little curio to get another class thinking about how they might get the balloon inside the bottle. And you can clearly choose colours to match school colours, relevant holidays, and of course, because we're talking about balloons, maybe even a special birthday. If you do get any nice results, as always, send them our way to share via the Education in Chemistry contact pages. We love to see what you guys get up to.